Welcome back to Biology by Shravanti. Today we are going to learn about the applications of biotechnology. So before going into topic, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please do like, share and subscribe to my channel. So let us start with the applications of biotechnology. So this biotechnology is act as an umbrella, that means it covers completely, it acts as a broad spectrum in all aspects like scientific application. It is used in every sector, from the health to the agriculture fields, and also in industry, environmental, and in the genomics. You can see the flow chart given below. Biotechnology, when it is coming for the industrial biotechnology, it is used in the production of enzymes, protein engineering, metabolic engineering, and also metabolics. For coming for the genomics, whole genome sequences prepared with the RDNA technology, gene function with the help of the reverse genetics and bioinformatics is also completely based upon the biotechnology. Next, microbial biotechnology, that is nothing but microbial genomics, biofertilizers, biopesticides are also used with the help of the biotechnology. Next, coming for the environmental biotechnology. Under environmental biotechnology, we deal with about the pollution control, biofuels are prepared, bioremediations, and also biodiversity is also completely depend upon the biotechnology. Next, coming for the animal biotechnology. Animal biotechnology is nothing but tissue culture, generative medicines, immunotechnology, and genetically modified animals are produced. Pharmacogenomics and gene therapy is also introduced with the help of the biotechnology. Next, coming for the plant biotechnology, like tissue culture, cell culture, genetically modified crops are produced, marker assistant selections are, and many others are produced with the help of, or completely directly or indirectly, every aspect of our life is completely depend upon the biotechnology. So let us learn each in detail about the biotechnology. First session is about the healthcare biotechnology. So healthcare biotechnology is nothing but, in this we are going to learn about the how the healthcare or how the biotechnology is related to the healthcare, either in the medicinal field or in the diagnostic of a disease or a production of a vaccine. So first let us see about the human insulin. So this human insulin is produced with the help of the RDNA technology. In previous video we have discussed about the RDNA technology and how to produce. So let us see the deep introduction of the human insulin. So this human insulin is a peptidal hormone produced from the islets of the Langer cells of pancreas, that means mainly in the beta cells, that is from the pancreas, from the islets of Langer, the insulin is produced. It was first discovered by Sir Edward Sharpe Scaffer in 1916 while studying about the islets of Langer. So for this scientist, when he was studying about the pancreas, so he discovered the insulin. So this insulin, main function of the insulin in the human body is to regulate the blood sugar level. Suppose diabetes mellitus, you have heard sugar patients. So this diabetes mellitus is a disease in which some people cannot produce insulin themselves. That means the insulin production is not developed. That means insulin production may not take place in some persons. So that condition we call it as a diabetes mellitus. So the another scientist, Hecuré et al., in 1977, a chemically synthesized DNA sequence of insulin for two chains of A and B are separated, inserted into two PBR 322 plasmid vector. So he did an experiment such that to produce the insulin hormone, such that because that the person who is suffering from diabetes mellitus, he is unable to produce the insulin hormone in his body to regulate the blood sugar level. So in order to overcome this problem, the scientist Hecuré has synthesized or started synthesizing. He considered or took the two DNA sequences of insulin. One is one chain with the A and another chain with the B. And he also took the two PBR plasmid vectors. Already plasmid, how to insert every mechanism I have discussed in the part 3. Okay, please, if you want, go to the part 3, there it will be clearly mentioned. Now these two PBR 32 vectors, plasmid vectors, he has taken, and in one vector he has inserted the chain A, in another vector with the chain B. So now the incident production of recombinant DNA tocopherol, as in this is inserted, that means these plasmids which you have inserted into the host body, such that the genes are inserted by the side of beta galactosidase gene of the plasmid. So then the recombinant plasmids were then separately transformed into E. coli host body. So these plasmid which they have after inserting, we call it as the rDNA. So now this rDNA is reinserted into a bacteria called as Escherichia coli. So after entering the host body, that means Escherichia coli starts to produce penicillase plus pre-proinsulin. Now the insulin is later separated by trypsin treatment. So in this way they produce the insulin which is necessary for the diabetes patients. So this is where it is used in the healthcare, how with the help of the biotechnology. Next, coming for the vaccine production, how do they produce the vaccine? For example, a vaccine is a biological preparation that produce an active acquired immunity against the certain disease. So in childhood we take many of the vaccines because in order to produce the immunity in our body. So this vaccine has given to a person to pre-incoming or to fight against the foreign particle if naturally it has entered into our body. Okay, so usually a vaccine consists of biological agent that represent the disease causing microorganism. So it is often made from a weakened or killed microorganism. So same micro, for example, polio virus, polio disease. So polio disease, the vaccine we take is called as a polio vaccine. So this polio vaccine consists of either it may be the organism, same polio virus may be killed, or disease causing it have virus, it should be weakened. Now that is synthesized or vaccine is produced with the help of the killed microorganism. So that is the way how we produce the vaccine. So biotechnology has offered more modern diagnostics test kits, like for many other tests like rickettsia, bacterial, viral vaccines, along with the radio label biological therapeutic for imaging and analysis. So these are some of the modern diagnostic kits they have produced by using the biotechnology, whether the person is suffering from any disease. So the vaccine have eliminated smallpox from polio and also other deadly disease causing for the last several decades. So because of production of the vaccine only, we are able to control the smallpox, polio and some other disease. So advanced vaccination is also produced by making the rDNA technology, that is recombinant vaccines, which may be potential to eradicate pre-coming non-communicable disease like cancer. So the technology may also improve, that means biotechnology, with the help of biotechnology, it is directly or indirectly it is very helpful for the human life. Next, oral vaccines are also synthesized to approach novel approach. Oral vaccine is nothing but taking through the drops in the mouth, general take. It is so the immune protein or certain pathogen is found to be active when it is administered orally. The gene corresponding to such protein is isolated and gene construction is produced, and this is introduced and expressed in a plant genome, which results in production of such immunogenic proteins in the part of the plant where it is expressed. So same, he has constructed the gene, and this is introduced and expressed in the plant genome, which results in production of many immunological proteins inside the plant where it has to be expressed. Thus, or these when fed into an animals or many plants, the person becomes vaccinated against certain pathogen. The same way the gene which is expressed in that plant, that is eaten or fed with the help of into the animals and humans, and that person would become vaccinated because the body immunity has been developed because of the pathogen. Such vaccines are also called as edible vaccine. An exciting invention is made by the production of melt in the mouth vaccine. That is nothing but mouth melt. When you drop that vaccine in the mouth, it gets melt away. It is kept under the tongue and it delivers it into the blood streams. The most important example is the production of flu vaccines by bacillus, which melts in the mouth. So the tremendous benefits of such vaccine is the comfort of administration of low cost. Tremendous benefits such as the vaccines is most comfortable for the administration and low cost and ease of storage. So this is about the oral vaccines. So next one is the how the biotechnology is used in the agricultural field. So coming for the applications in biotechnology in the agriculture field, it involves the scientific techniques like genetically modified crops are produced, BT cotton is produced, pest resistant plants are produced. So it helps in modifying plants, animals and microorganisms and improve their quality and productivity is also increased. Like coming for the tissue culture, it is used in micropropagation, that is to produce large scale production of the plant in very short duration. So that means with the help of the tissue culture, if the crop produced for 1 year, so because of the tissue culture, because of the micropropagation, the crop may produce within the 6 months only. So that is with the help of the biotechnology. Next, the tissue culture technique is also a best method for storing germplasm and maintaining a specific genetic type. That is nothing but the clone specific, that is also carried with the help of the biotechnology. So this technique is used in those plants which produce recalcitrant seeds or produce high variable varieties of seeds. So this is about the where that is nothing but in agriculture. So in agriculture purpose, because of the microorganism, because of the biotechnology, biofertilizers are produced, biopesticides are produced, and genetically modified crops are produced, BT cotton, golden rice, many other crops are produced with the help of the biotechnology. So this is about the agriculture field. Next, coming for the gene therapy. So gene therapy, how the biotechnology is helpful for the gene therapy. So a gene is a stretch of DNA required to make functional products such as a part or all of a protein. That means complete protein, it has to be produced. So during gene therapy, DNA that codes specific gene is delivered into an individual cell in the body. So gene therapy is treatment of disease by replacing or by altering or by supplementing of gene that is absent or abnormal and whose absence or abnormalities is responsible for the disease. So gene therapy is nothing but if at all a person suffering with, that means any gene is missing in their body. So that is replaced with the help of the gene therapy, or it should be altered. If any defective gene is there, it should be removed, or if at all the gene is completely absent, so there has to be replaced. If at all any abnormalities are there, so it should be change that is taken place with the help of the gene therapy. So most if not all the diseases have the genetic factors. So genetic factors can be wholly or partially responsible for many of the disease. For example, cystic fibrosis, these are some of the disorders like cystic fibrosis, hemophilia, muscular dystrophy. Change in the gene directly results in the condition. So this type of treatments or this type of disease are treated with the help of the gene therapy. So in another condition such as high cholesterol, maybe high BP or genetic or environmental factors also intact to cause some of the disease. So there are more than 5000 different human genetic diseases known to be caused by single gene defect, like sickle cell anemia. In order the RBC cell should be of biconcave, because of the sickle cell anemia the shape of the RBC cells change and the problem or the disease is caused. into the sickle cell. Next, thalassemia. These are all the many of the diseases: hemophilia, albinism, alectropenia. Many a disease are treated with the help of the or disease causing gene disorders. So this is also treated with the help of the gene therapy. So let us see one the way how they will treat with the help of the gene therapy. For example, if any defective gene is there, so replacing of missing gene or defective gene. Next, deliver genes that speed the destruction of cancer cells, because of the in the case of the cancer, the cells continuously go on increasing. So in order to control that, they deliver, they place a gene, and it supply the gene that cause the cancerous cell to revert back to the normal cells. Deliver bacterial or viral genes as the formation of vaccination, or deliver DNA to antigen expression and generation of immune response, and also helps in supply of gene for impairing viral replication, and also help in provides the gene that promote or impair the growth of new tissue, and also deliver genes that stimulate the healing of damaged tissue. So these are some of the points. Next, going for the forms of the gene therapy. One is germline theory, gene therapy, and another one somatic cell gene therapy. So germline gene therapy is nothing but in this method, the healthy gene can be introduced into the germ cells like sperm cells or egg cells or early embryo cells. So it allows the transmission of modified genetic information to the next generation. Though it is highly effective, it's counteracting genetic disorder. So it is not encouraged for the application on human beings due to variety of techniques on ethical reason. But if you want to modify gene, so that gene is introduced into the sperms or egg cells. Next, coming for the somatic cell gene therapy. So in this time, the gene is introduced into the somatic cells like bone marrow, hepatic cell, fibrocyst, endothelium, endothelium, pulmonary epithelial cell, and many central nervous system, endocrine cells. So this gene is introduced into some of the somatic cells. So the modification of somatic cells only affects the person being treated, and modified chromosome cannot be passed on to the future generation. That means here it is not passed to the next generation. It stops there itself. So somatic gene therapy is only feasible option, and clinical trials have already employed for this treatment for acquiring the disease such as cancer and rheumatoid arthritis, and also used in treating for the blood disorders including SCDI, Gaucher's disease, familia, sickle cell anemia. So in this way, these are some of the techniques where the gene therapy is used in the biotechnology. So in the next class, we'll discuss about the other types of the applications in the biotechnology. So thank you for this session. If you like, please do like, share and subscribe to my channel.